today all the trade unions have together given the call for a 3-day Mahapadav and on the 12-point charter of demands. All the trade unions have been struggling, launching different programs on the 12-point charter of demands since 2009. So basically all these 12 demands are the demands of the entire working class. Though today BMS is not in this particular movement, but the demands are of the entire working class. And not only the working class, the demands that the trade unions have raised also are of the common people, like the price rise and strengthening of the public distribution system and employment generation. These are pension for all, social security for all, including the agricultural workers and other sections. These are all demands pertaining to all the toiling sections of the people. And on this, since 2009, we have been demanding, but the government has not done anything. Particularly after the BJP government has come to power, they are going ahead with amending the labor laws in favor of the employers, and they have formed four. They have decided to form four courts, and already three are there: the code on wages, the code on industrial relations, and the code on social security. The other code on safety at workplace, that is still pending. But all the three courts are against the interests of the workers. Whatever benefits the workers were getting through the existing labor laws will be removed, and that will benefit the employers. So the trade unions are opposing this. And in addition to that, the minimum wages of 18,000. According to the 7th pay commission recommendation, which the government has accepted, they have accepted the 18,000 per month as minimum wage, whereas actually if you calculate on the basis of the ILC recommendations along with Supreme Court direction, it will come to more than 26,000. But the trade unions are demanding 18,000 because the government has already accepted the recommendation of the 7th pay commission, but that the government till now is not ready to concede. Similarly, about the contract workers. Today, the number of contract workers is increasing everywhere, and the contract workers doing the same job are getting half, even one-third or one-quarter wages of the that of permanent workers doing the same job. The Supreme Court also have given the judgment. The earlier acts are all there that the same work. Contract workers should not be employed in permanent or perennial nature of work that they are doing. And if they are doing the same job, should be same wages should be there, but the government is not ready to implement that. So these are the basic demands. Amendment, stop the amendment to the labor laws in favor of the employers. Contract workers should be given the same wages and benefits. Minimum wages should be implemented. Prices should be brought down. And another ILC recommendation that all the around 1 crore scheme workers are there in our country. Most of them are women. The government talks of women's empowerment, but it is not even ready to recognize them as workers. They are all called volunteers, social workers, activists. Different names are given, and they are not paid minimum wages. They are paid some honorarium, which starts from nil for ASHA workers to 1,000 for midday meal workers, 3,000, 1,500 for the Anganwadi workers and helpers. It varies like that. So that we are demanding that all the scheme workers should be first designated as workers, recognized as workers, and they should be paid minimum wages, social security benefits. And now the government's move to privatize and dismantle all these schemes should be stopped immediately. So on this, around more than 1 lakh workers have come from all over the country, starting from Jammu, Kashmir to Kerala, Tamil Nadu, etc. And they will be staying, some of them will be staying for all the 3 days, and many more will be coming tomorrow and day after tomorrow. And day after tomorrow, we'll decide the immediate future plan from here. Already, the National Convention has decided to go to give the call to the workers to prepare for an indefinite strike, countrywide indefinite strike. So before that also, to prepare the workers for the countrywide general strike, we are going to give a call day after tomorrow. We have already started thinking about that. It will be announced day after tomorrow.